I just wanted to be on record that I spend 90% of my life in a sports bra, and I'm wearing like a real bra today, and it is killing me. Good morning, vlog. Excuse how crazy my hair looks right now. I am actually on my way to go get it done. So I'm really, really, really excited. I'm of course also really, 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 really late. But yeah, this is what it looks like right now. I'm so embarrassed. My hair is disgusting. I haven't washed it since Monday and it's Thursday. I meant to get up this morning and wash my hair, but the kids had a 2-hour delay. Oh great, so I'm just gonna have to ride like this. But yeah, the kids had a 2-hour delay, which threw off my whole morning. I ended up not having enough time, and I'm texting Kelly and I'm like, hey, my hair's gross. Would you rather come wet and clean or gross and dry? And she was like, either one, it's fine. I won't judge. Oh good, green light. Don't turn. Stay green, please. Where did my hair tie go? Did I seriously lose my hair tie? Oh no, it's on my arm. This guy's like, bitch, what are you doing? I'm sitting in the middle of a space. I'm taking it up, okay? All right, I look still like a potato or a toe, and you guys are falling over. So yeah, I will be showing you guys what my hair looks like. I feel like, you know, like how I was saying a couple vlogs ago that I felt like I was going through like a bad divorce or a bad breakup. I feel like this is the first step to like get myself back on track. So I feel like this is good. Okay, I'm here, so I gotta go. My hair feels so healthy. It just feels like, I don't know, it feels so good and so healthy. I can't wait to see what it looks like when it's curly, but she straightened it for me and she did heavy highlights. So it's like the blondest it's been in years. I took off all my makeup, so I look a little bit weird, but I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. I'm telling you, you guys, if you need to get your hair done, go to Kelly. I'm not going to put her actual salon like on YouTube because who knows what weirdos watch my videos. The end goal is going to be more like a very pale, light, icy, cool-toned blonde. And then I might have to, she said, add in some low lights so that it maintains like some depth, because like right now you can still see some of my natural color. Why is everybody driving slow? Is there like a cop around? What am I missing? And, all right, I'm home, so bye. Nothing worse than waking up late and having your sun run late, and hate when my kids are late for school. We both like went back to bed thinking, oh, we don't need to get up yet. We have a little bit of time to sleep. Oh, I feel like the world's worst parent right now. Oh my gosh. I hope that this is not an indicator of how my day is going to start, because I actually have some pretty big plans and quite a bit of stuff to do. Meanwhile, like, again, it's been raining so much in Indiana that like all of this rain has been like sucked up into the ground, and the green is so freaking plush and thick and green. Did I say the green? I meant the grass. Guys, I'm half asleep. I don't even know. But it's Friday! Yay! Right? Yay! Super yay! So excited! I don't know what I'm saying. I'm just gonna go home. I'm gonna go back to bed until I can wake up and start the day completely over. Hey, you guys! Happy Cinco de Mayo! Anthony, you can't see him because he's sitting over there and doesn't want to be on camera. But we are going to go have some drinks with our friends before we come back and watch episode 4?
Yes, episode 4.
Episode 4 of Game of Thrones. Do you want to say hi?
Not really.
What's on the front of that truck? Is that a Slurpee?
No, it's a soda cup. It's the markers that Hot Box Pizza puts on their delivery carts.
Oh, they like Tool. And Soundgarden? Is that Soundgarden?
Yep. And the Beatles.
I can't see anything
the
else.
The monkeys. Faith okay. No more.
Cool, we could hang out with him. He'd be our friend. Is it Hot Box Pizza that always makes me think of Jukebox Hero?
Hot Box Pizza.
I've never had them.
Yeah, we did. We had them once when we were down in Indy.
Oh, yeah. They tasted like soggy paper towels.
Yeah, it wasn't very good.
I wasn't impressed. And their cups don't look like that. Hot Box Pizza, it's false advertisement. Okay, he looks like somebody who listens to Tool. I'm judging.
Are you saying he is like a Tool?
I'm not saying he is like a Tool, and people who listen to Tool are not necessarily tools.
Okay, just clarifying.
I listen to Tool, you listen to Tool. Everybody should listen to Tool.
You listen to Tool, you listen to Tool. Everybody listens to Tool.
That's like the rocker Oprah. I even listened to Perfect Circle. Oh, I'm gonna take up the super size spot that's just for me. All right, let's go in and get our drink on. Do that again.
No.
Do it again.
No.
Do it again.
No.
The people want to see it.
No.
The people demand to see it.
No.
Do it.
No.
Do it now.
No.
You suck. All right. So today is, I believe it's May 7th. I don't know. I need like a calendar. I was going to say I need a calendar always on me, but I always have my phone. So my phone has a calendar. So technically I do always have a calendar. But somehow I'm still completely always unaware of what the day is. Wow, that guy is ready for anything. He's got like his bicycle and then he's got a backpack that has his skateboard. Okay, I just thought that that plant looked like an anteater. What's up you guys? How are you guys doing? I just dropped Ezra off at practice. I can barely see because I don't have sunglasses and you all know that I'm a vampire and my eyes bleed when I am in direct sunlight. Does that make sense? First of all, if you have not seen the YouTuber, I think his name is I Am Brandon Ferris. I'm linking him down below. Seriously, I watched probably 17 of his videos last night, and I watched several of them multiple times. The yoga one and the tarantula one, the zebra tarantula one, are the absolute best.
Reach the arms up, and I want you to spread your fingertips apart like crazy. So when I'm exhale, Ardha Hanumanasana.
I feel more stressed doing this. Okay, Artemis, you dirty astronaut.
There's a tarantula in here. He ain't moving. He's dead. My handshake. You better fall out or this ain't happening. He eats zebras. He came out at me aggressively, okay? Of course I'm gonna react. I got tarantula legs all over my Prius seats.
Yeah, so I will link that down below. Second of all, like, I really want to announce my praise and love and adoration for concealer. Because, yeah, I ran smack into my door today. We have a door that the hinge is broke, or it's broken. And so, like, when you're standing in the bathroom, it kind of, like, shuts partway. And I was, like, in fast cleaning mode. And so I was zipping around the bathroom. And I turned right around and ran smack into the door. And I have, like, this bruise and this bubble on my forehead. Somehow my big schnoz missed the door, which I'm okay with. But yeah, that was how my day started pretty much. And then I'm gonna throw some clips and you guys, I have the funniest story. I don't know, I feel like it's really funny. So a cinco de mayo, I filmed before when Anthony and I were like getting ready to go out to eat and everything. But while we were at dinner, I think we all had a little bit too much, too many trifectas. And we started prank calling people. First we started with my son, then we got to the point that I ended up calling Jeff's niece, I think it was. I don't know like where all this story came from, but she really, I feel like she really bought it. The conversation lasted like over 5 minutes and she was like, what? Oh my gosh, are you serious? But I was telling her that my name was Bethany Harmony and that I was calling from HR at Chrysler because somebody lost a finger, and I just wanted to call and make sure she had all of her fingers, and somehow it, like, went from that to being just the tip of the finger, and I was like,
yeah, the police came, and they fingerprinted it, and I guess good for the person, because, like, they're not in the system, so they're not a criminal or a sex offender. I just wanted to call and make sure that, you know, you still have all your fingers and everything.
And she's like, oh, yeah, like, I would go straight to, you know, human resources, and I would report that, and I'm like, yeah, I don't know why this person didn't want to get workman's comp. It was really, really funny. Then I went on and I posted on Facebook. I was like,
yo, like, Bethany Harmony,
who I don't even know,
just called me from Chrysler,
which I don't even work at,
and said someone lost a penis.
Yeah, I even, like, found a Google image of, like, the tip of a pinky cut off and posted it on Facebook. People were like, oh my gosh, I haven't heard anything about this. It must have been the Kokomo transmission plant. So for everybody who watches this, and if you thought I was being serious, I apologize. I took a joke way too far. But after having an unmentionable amount of drinks, Jeff, Chris, and I were in his car, and we were driving back to their house to pick something up. And in the meantime, like, these police start, like, driving past us, and I decided that it should be a Blair Witch moment, and I should have, like, a moment by moment retelling of what's going on. I enjoyed it. You probably all are gonna think it's stupid, but I don't care. I'm 37 with the maturity level of, like, a 7-year-old, and I hope you guys enjoy it. So here's some clips of that. You guys, we just got passed by two cop cars, and I'm pretty sure they might be on the track of
three.
The pinky. Was it three cop cars?
Three.
Okay, my friend says three cop cars.
And there's more coming behind us.
More coming behind us? Oh my gosh, you guys, this pinky thing is serious.
There's something really wrong going on out here.
Something is really bad.
That's a dog. Like a dog, police dog?
That's not a good thing.
Did they find a body?
I don't know. They could. Someone could have got killed over there. I got a feeling this other, the fourth cop may have went on the other side. Because there's another side. But they'd all turn their lights off. That's screwy.
I know, because they're not trying to draw attention. I don't know. I feel so bad. But, like, honestly, I wish I recorded me on the phone with her. Although I wouldn't have posted it, because since it's someone that I don't know, but someone I know does know.
We know.
I wouldn't have posted her reaction, because then I would have felt really mean. But oh my gosh, you guys. I thought it was funny. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Right now, though, I'm dying. I am on my way to TJ Maxx for no other reason than to see, like, what makeup they have for sale, because I have $10, so why not spend it? I don't know, I just needed to get out, get some sunshine, get some fresh air, and do some retail therapy. You know, it's been like a whole week since I've been to TJ Maxx, and what if they have something new that I really, really need? I can't let good makeup, you know, not live its lifelong fulfillment of being bought, purchased, and used. I'm doing it for the makeup, you guys. It's for the makeup. Okay, so I'm at TJ Maxx. Let's hope that I don't find anything to spend $10 on, because I really shouldn't be spending $10. Although, I mean, it's $10. You guys are always falling over. Get it together. Seriously? This bird has some nerve. All right, I am so excited. I ended up calling Anthony to come meet me at TJ Maxx, because I did not trust myself with my credit card, and yeah, I also ran into my friend Delina, which I don't know, Delina, if you watch my vlogs or not, but if you do, hey girl, if not, like, how rude. But yeah, I got way more than I should have gotten at TJ Maxx, but I did put back more than I bought, which I feel like is a huge, huge plus. First of all, I just got these. These are Absolute New York. I guess I should have made sure they were cruelty free. Oh, they are cruelty free. Okay, sweet. They say cruelty free. Nice. But they have, like, green tea. I don't know, but I'm always in need of makeup wipes, and I know I just bought makeup wipes, but yeah, I'm already, you know, needing more again. So I got those. I'm out of all of my sheet masks, and they had this 5-pack. It has a revitalizing rose mask, a nourishing nourishing avocado mask, pore minimizing charcoal mask, anti-aging collagen mask, get on my face now, and an anti-shine green tea mask. So I was really excited about that. Then I swear, every time I get on Instagram, I see these all of the time. These are those like under eye patches that you see all the people put under their eyes. But they're Panda Hydra Gel Eye Patch Deep Moisturizing. I don't know. It's a Korean beauty thing. And I'm telling you what, people in Korea do not age. So I trust their judgment. Ooh. They're so weird. Okay, so I might have a serious problem with touching these. Because I don't know if you guys know about my texture issues. But... oh, it's just like jelly, like sliding around. You know what it reminds me of? That jellied cranberry sauce that like people keep serving at Thanksgiving when, you know, cranberry sauce, homemade, fresh from real cranberries is so much better. But it comes with this thing. So maybe I like don't have to touch it. I can just be like splattering it on my face. But I am now going to be insta-famous because I have under eye pads. Gel pads. And then this is where I'm really excited and is where I spent probably most of the money and where I had the least amount of control. I don't know. I got like a ton of lips. Well, I say a ton, but I only got four. This is the Too Faced Melted Latex Unicorn Tears. Why is that guy staring at me? Weirdo. You guys know I'm obsessed with like cool tones right now, and this is purple. Like, oh, wow. Oh, yeah. My lips are like super dry. That is freaking awesome. Like a unicorn just cried on my lips. I'm in love. This is Urban Decay Vice Special Effects. I was so excited. I thought this was the prettiest color ever. Look at this. Again, it's like a cool tone blue purple shift thing. I don't know. Let's put this on my lips too. Ooh, it's very wet.
What?
So obviously I need to work with this product a little bit because application, not the best. Shade, however, is freaking awesome. I also got a metallic purple, like iridescent looking, another unicorn like lipstick. Oh wow, that's like a terrible removal. So terrible application, terrible removal. Oh, it's so pretty. Oh, that is so pretty. Okay, so obviously, again, really bad application. It doesn't feel gritty, but it looks like it has like super huge like glitter chunks. I really like that. So again, super duper happy with that purchase. And then finally, and I would not have bought this if it were not for the fact that it was at TJ Maxx. I don't own anything Kat Von D, and I'm not even going to get into the... I have unicorn tears all over my entire hands. But I'm not going to get into the whole controversy about Kat Von D. No, it's been done. But they had a whole bunch of her lipsticks. And they have like this really pretty like charcoaly black. And I've been wanting to get a black, but I don't want like a black black. I wanted this like charcoal color, but then with the shimmer. Okay, so my camera stopped recording. Trying to take off your lipstick and not take off your foundation that's all over your face is a serious, serious struggle. Let's see, Kat Von D. Are you even worth all the controversy? What is happening? I'm super, and I'm like I'm really pushing. Studded Kiss Cream Lipstick. What did I buy? Did it say rotisserie? No, Rosetto. What does that mean? Is it supposed to be sheer? It's like so... it feels like putting on like... you know the lipstick that you get when you go to the Halloween store and you have to like cake it on? This does not feel creamy. Obviously, I need to invest in a liner if I'm going to wear black lipstick because putting black lipstick on is not one of my talents. Oh, good. I got it on my teeth. Now, this one does feel gritty. Once you get past like that top, like, ooh, gross, skin of the lipstick, it feels like it goes on a lot better. It just looks funny because how am I supposed to fix that? I got it on my chin. I'm great at this, you guys. Application and lipstick, That's a professional job right there. All right, unicorn tears. Come through for me. Okay, I actually like that a lot. Okay, so I think I'm gonna end the vlog here. I noticed that I got a whole bunch of, well, not a whole bunch, I got like 10 more subscribers in the last couple of days, and I'm really, really excited about it. Thank you guys so much. Welcome to my mess, that is my life. But thanks you guys for watching. You guys mean so much to me, and I will see you in my next video. Make sure to subscribe if you have not subscribed. Bye!